Today, we're demonstrating a GMR sensor interface to a low-end microcontroller. We're using a Trinket board, which costs $6 or $7, based on an ATtiny 85 microcontroller that costs less than a dollar. This micro is ideal because it has a differential amplifier with a gain of 20. It's only an 8-pin microcontroller, but that's enough. There are 5 I/O pins. We're using 2 pins for the sensor outputs. A digital output drives an LED indicator. We have an analog output. Or we could use these 2 pins for I2C. We took this USB resistor off the Trinket to avoid loading the sensor, so we have jumpers to add it back in for programming. Here's the assembly. The Trinket board. The sensor on a modified demo board. And this board with test points and jumpers to switch between operating and programming. We're powering it with 2 lithium button cells. It auto zeroes on power up. The meter shows the analog output, which is amplified and temperature compensated. The microcontroller saturation corresponds pretty closely to the sensor linear range. The red LED is set for a threshold in software, which could be calibrated. Here's the program. This section is parameters and setup. We use an Arduino IDE, but you could also use AVR Dude or the microchip development environment. This code selects the differential amplifier and sets the gain to 20. We correct for offset and temperature, which often isn't necessary, but is easy to do. Temperature correction uses the typical temperature coefficient of 400 ppm per degree C. Finally, we write the analog output and turn on the LED if the sensor exceeds the threshold. So the lab results are in. GMR sensors are easy to interface directly to inexpensive microcontrollers. They're sensitive, high output, precise, stable, and low noise. Here's what we used for this demo and where to get it.